Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. The father accused of killing his 3-year-old daughter is now being held without bail. Joe Carl Bureau was arraigned this morning in the death of Jaylee Bureau. He is charged with second-degree murder. The toddler was found unresponsive at a home in Concord last March and later died. An autopsy showed she died from blunt force trauma to the abdomen. Well, he is accused of killing his 11-year-old stepdaughter, and this afternoon a hearing will be held to determine if Wendell Noyes is competent to stand trial. Noyes is charged with second-degree murder, a charge that could put him in prison for the rest of his life. According to the Attorney General's office, Noyes killed his stepdaughter, Selena Cass, back in July of 2011. Cass was last seen at 9 o'clock at night on July 26th. The 11-year-old girl was working on a computer at their West Stewartstown home. Cass's disappearance would set off a massive manhunt that ended 6 days later. The girl's body was pulled from the Connecticut River. Prior to the discovery of the body and in the years afterwards, Noyes denied having anything to do with Cass's disappearance. Today's competency hearing has already been postponed twice and was originally scheduled for 11 o'clock this morning, but we're told it will now begin at 1 o'clock this afternoon. WMUR's Amy Covino is in the courtroom for the hearing and will have a complete wrap-up beginning on News 9 at 5 and, of course, the latest here on WMUR.com. One person was killed in a fire in Nashua when firefighters arrived at the River Pines Mobile Home Park last night. They found heavy fire coming from the back of the home. Firefighters found a body inside a little while later. Right now, the cause of that blaze remains under investigation. Well, did you feel a little shaking in Boscawen? You were not alone. A 2.0 magnitude earthquake was felt in several surrounding towns last night. There were no reports of damage or injuries, but several of you shared what you experienced. Ruth in Belmont says, "My dog barked before I felt it." And Amy says, "We could feel the shake, and it sounded like a loud rumble of thunder." We spoke with a senior research scientist at Weston Observatory who says the quake didn't come as a shock.
It turns out that the most active area for earthquakes in all of New England is roughly between Concord, New Hampshire, and up to the Laconia area in the Lakes region. We have more earthquakes per year from this area than any other part of New England, and this earthquake was near the southern end of that band.
Dr. Ebel says he isn't ruling out the possibility of smaller aftershocks within the next few days. Well, new today, this warm stretch of weather has led to the Tamworth sled dog race being canceled. It was scheduled to run this upcoming weekend after being postponed, but with little snow and no ice, it won't happen this year. Starting tonight at 5, a jury has been chosen for the trial over a deadly stabbing. Right now, those jurors are visiting the Queen City Club where it happened. And the opioid crisis has created a new burden for heart surgeons thanks to a specific side effect of those drugs. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.